I'm going to finish up our strong acid, strong base titration without my face in the window. Wanted to show two quick things. One is table 14.4 from the textbook that allows you to work extra titration problems. The ones that are shown in red here are ones that we did. The ones in black would be great extra practice problems for you to work through. Make sure that you know where you are in a titration and how to calculate the pH. The second quick thing I wanted to mention or to post is that the most common indicator you've been using in chemistry so far is phenolphthalein, and that is way down here toward the bottom. But realize that there are many other indicators that can be used in acid-base reactions. And so what these are showing is the pH range along the x-axis of when an indicator would change and the different colors of these indicators. I always like to tell students in my lecture that one of the courses I took, we titrated for an entire semester. Super fun. Not. The hardest indicator ever that I used was bromophenol blue because it starts at a light yellow and it's much lighter than is shown in here, by the way, and ends at a light blue. And so your equivalence point, you're looking for a faint green color in between the two. Everybody's literally walking around lab holding up their flasks asking if it looked green. Super fun. So anyway, just like to share that there are other options out there. Phenolphthalein is by far the most universal.